Poony, what were you thinking, going out by yourself? Don't you know how dangerous it is?
It's okay. Toba helped me. And we met some kind strangers who helped us, and...
Kind strangers? What made you so sure they were so kind, huh? Oh, I suppose they had kind stranger written on their foreheads?
Yeah, actually, they did. In big, bold letters.
Don't talk back to me. The Mountain King problem still hasn't been solved. What would I do if I lost you too? No dinner for you tonight.
They were good people, Dad. Dinner or no dinner.
Hello again, Mooney.
It's Miss Paimon and Mr. Traveler. Dad, it's them. They're the ones who helped me. And I promised we'd take care of them if they came to visit.
Oh, so you're the kind strangers. Well, I'm Trinidad. Apparently, you helped my daughter today, so if there's anything you need, just ask. As an elder of the Scions of the Canopy, I've got some influence around here. Now, I trust that you're sensible people who know better than to take advantage of their...
Yep, just helping a neighbor. We're not looking for anything in return.
Oh? Well, let's hope so.
Dad, please! They're not bad people! They've eaten at the same table with Kanich before! Be nice to them!
Kanich? Wait! I heard that two mysterious travelers from afar showed up at the Stadium of the Sacred Flame. Are they... you?
And Paimon's the other!
I do apologize. A lot's been going on in our tribe lately, and I suppose the pressure must be getting to me. I can't believe I was so rude to you. I feel ashamed. We got off on the wrong foot. Can we, start over?
Oh, now we're talking. Seriously, though, don't worry about it. Already forgotten. We're just happy to see Hooney got home safe and sound.
Oh, you just arrived, I take it, and it would be my honor to give you a hero's welcome tonight.
Careful now! That's quite an about face! We've heard that kind of thing can lead to spontaneous combustion around these parts.
My dear traveler, you are very perceptive indeed. Go inside now, Hooney. Dad's got some important business to discuss.
Okay. Look after Mr. Traveler and Miss Paimon. They're very special guests.
Well, we'll hear you out, but we can't make any promises that we'll be able to help.
Well, this is a matter of utmost importance. Please, allow me to explain. For many years, our tribe has celebrated the Turnfire Night. It is a traditional ceremony among the Scions of the Canopy in which we remember our ancestor, Burkina, and his companion, Kangamato, the Mountain King. Burkina was a hero who bore the ancient name Malipo, and Kangamato was a powerful Yumkasaur warrior. Together, they fought against the Abyss. They were victorious, but it came at a great cost. Burkina paid with his life. The Mountain King survived, but was contaminated by the Abyss, and he remains in hibernation to this day. Normally, Yumkasaurs never live longer than a century. It is possible that the Abyssal Power is responsible for his unnaturally long lifespan. Oh, that's right. The Mountain King is a living symbol of our glory, but even this glory comes at a price. The Abyssal Power inside him is highly sensitive, and when it is disturbed, he awakens and flies into a blind rage, attacking anything that moves. So, besides the ceremony, another important part of Turnfire Night each year is cleansing the abyssal power inside the Mountain King so that he will remain sound asleep. However, abyss-related incidents have been on the rise in that land lately, as I'm sure you're both aware. As a result, it has become increasingly difficult to keep the Mountain King in hibernation. Only 5 months have passed since the last Turnfire Night, and he's already showing signs of instability.
Has he woken up again?
He has. We managed to contain the situation by performing a makeshift ceremony right away, but it was a close call. He could reawaken at any moment. Also, he attacked and wounded my companion, Nana, during the ceremony. She became contaminated by the Abyss as a result, and...
We heard. Such a tragedy. We're really sorry for your loss.
Yes, and Nana wasn't the first. Anyway, right now we're preparing for an exceptional Turnfire Night ceremony, and we need to find a suitable flame bearer. From what I've heard about your adventures, I believe you would be perfect for the role. Of course. Plus, he's a bona fide hero who inherited the Malipo name.
Oh, you mean Kneech?
Yes, he's the one. A hero worth his weight in gold. And unfortunately for us, he's all too aware of that. No prizes for guessing what he said when I asked him to host a Turnfire Night outside of the annual schedule. An exceptional ceremony? Oh, I'll have to charge an exceptional prize. I swear, no other concept exists in that boy's brain. I'm not the one to usually talk about people behind their backs, but I'm convinced the Wyab got hit on the head and took a wrong turn the day it chose to give that ancient name to him. I mean, have you ever heard of a hero whose mantra is, "What's your asking price?" Oh, and don't get me started on that insufferable Ahau he hangs around with. Thinks he's God's gift to mankind. Pompous fool.
Yeah, Paimon has to agree on that last part.
Anyway, the fact is, the ceremony can just as easily be done without him as long as we can find someone else. And besides, you two seem like much better candidates. what do you think? Wonderful! I can't thank you enough. Huni was right about you. You have kindness in your hearts. Come with me to the other side of the mountain. I'll bring you up to speed on each step of the ceremony. As experienced warriors, I'm sure you'll pick it up in no time.
Achoo! Curses! Who dares insult the great Kahul Ahau behind his back?
Oh, great Kahul Ahau, bless you!
Shut your filthy mouth, worm of the abyss! Your putrid words defile the air we breathe! You make the almighty Dragon Lord, Kahul Ahau, sick to the stomach!
Speaking as a member of the Abyss Order, that's music to my ears. Exactly the kind of reaction we're going for. But on a personal level, I gotta say, it's pretty hurtful.
Ugh, never have we heard such brazen blustering from someone who is inches from death. Up yours, Four Eyes! We spit in your face!
Okay, well, that I am at a loss to explain. How do I manage to stay so chirpy and cheerful? I can only guess it's some kind of powerful magic. But I digress. Mr. Kneech, I admit it, you, sir, are a legendary hunter. Still, the only reason you caught me is that I was reluctant to run away. You see, I'm very interested in the lore of your tribe.
Kay?
Is that it? Kay? Aren't you intrigued to know what it is about you guys that prompted a visit from the Abyss? It's the extreme sports! The other day, I narrowly avoided getting hit by a very brave soul who just leaped off a cliff. I think you call it bungee jumping? Anyway, I was very impressed. That is what I call embracing the spirit of adventure. Look, I even did a painting inspired by the bravery and freedom of the Scions of the Canopy.
You scum-sucking swine! I swear, if you go bungee jumping, it'll be without a rope! Head first off the tallest cliff, with a band of hunters on your tail, and nowhere left to run! And a bottomless cesspit waiting for you on the ground!
You say that, but I get the sense that Mr. Kneech isn't planning to take my life right now. On top of that, I'm tired of spying on you from afar. So why don't we just negotiate a comfortable operating distance that works for both of us? I've heard that the most important thing in human relationships is to respect each other's boundaries. What do you say, Mr. Kinich?
Or you could tell me what it is you're really after.
What?
And then I'll name my price.
The Abyss contamination is back. No surprises there. No doubt that explains the Mountain King's recent activity. See those torches over there? Those are the Sacred Flame offshoots that we requested from the Stadium of the Sacred Flame. They contain the power of the Pyro Archon.
Are you saying that the Sacred Flame and the Turnfire are the same thing?
Well, for ceremonial purposes, at least. Sending someone to the Night Kingdom to retrieve the legendary Turnfire isn't exactly an option. More to the point, though, the Sacred Flame is able to burn away abyssal filth, so that's why we use it in the ceremony.
Gotcha! So basically, we just need to clean up the filth with the Sacred Flame.
Well, that's one part of it, yes, but the complete ceremony is a bit more complicated than that. First, the Flame Bearer must collect a kindling of the Sacred Flame from the starting point, then use a grappling hook to fly up into the sky and light each of the Sacred Flame pillars. Then, they must go down into the canyon, all the way into the cave where the Mountain King slumbers, lighting braziers and the final altar along the way. The most skilled Flame Bearers can accomplish all of this without touching the ground once. As much as I hate to admit it, Kinich is capable of this.
Wow! He can do all that flying without ever falling to the ground? Well, of course Paimon can! It'd be much harder for you guys!
Well, don't worry. It's not a requirement of the ceremony. You're allowed to touch the ground. The only thing you're not allowed to do is turn back. The Flame Bearer must always keep moving forward. You can't skip a pillar, then come back to it after lighting the next one. To do so would be to disrespect our ancestors.
So, what actually happens if you do turn back? Surely the fires don't just go out.
If you're not careful, you might get burned.
What about today, then? Does the same rule apply?
Oh, no. Don't worry. Today is just a practice. The order doesn't matter. You just need to take the Sacred Flame, cleanse the filth, then go light all the braziers. Are you ready? I'll repeat all the key points again. Gather the kindling, cleanse the filth, and light all the braziers. I'll wait for you at the end.
There's abyssal filth over there! Let's burn it away with the sacred flame!
I knew I was right about you. You have outperformed all of the other previous candidates. If there was an ancient name for outstanding flame bearers, I'm sure the Wyab would consider you for the honor.
Yeah, although it would probably take Paimon quite a bit longer.
All right, now there's still a few days left until the ceremony. And I should probably get back so I can inform the chief and the other elders that I have found the flame bearer we need.
Oh, you mean they've still got to sign off on it?
Some of them are still hoping we can come to an agreement with Kanich, but that's only because they haven't seen you in action. Still, I'm the one responsible for securing a flame bearer, and my recommendation is you.
Just for Paimon's own peace of mind, are you sure it's not going to be a problem having outlanders take on such an important role in your ceremony?
See that place over there? There was a time, long before the age of Burkina and the Mountain King, when we, Scions of the Canopy, called that our home. After a period of upheaval, our ancestors were forced to move away. Now, It has become a place where our youths go to develop courage and kindle a spirit of adventure. If we fail to keep the threat posed by the Mountain King at bay, it might not be long before we have to move again and find a new home. So, to answer your question, I think everyone will agree that you are the right choice.
Fair enough. Desperate times call for desperate measures.
I'll need you to drop by my place at some point before the ceremony, if that's all right. There are still a few final details that we need to discuss.
Okay, see you later then.
You have my gratitude.
We've helped out with a lot of other local festivals before, but this one feels a little different. Anyway, let's take a break before heading back to Trinidad's place.